The NFL playoffs are on EA Sports, and we've got a packed house here at Mercedes-Benz Stadium in downtown Atlanta. Ahead, we'll decide the second entrant to next week's NFC title game, as we've got a great one in store between the Carolina Panthers and the Atlanta Falcons. Punch the fourth and final ticket to the conference championship round. We'll know soon enough as we are underway here on a January afternoon.
And this will go as a touchback, and they will begin things at the 25.
Is Derrick Henry, and he'll power his way forward for about 4 yards there on the first down carry.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a 4 yard run on first down.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. From the gun, it's Jackson. He dumps it off for Henry. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
That's going to be a good matchup for him, using him out of the backfield and telling those linebackers, hey, you're not only going to have to try and run with him, but you're going to have to try and tackle him in the open field.
From Falcon territory now, here's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Jackson. And just not enough on the throw there. Down around his feet and incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Second and 10. Now Jackson. And he'll slide to a halt here, still a little shy of the first down marker. He turned that into a nice gain, gets him 8 yards closer for third down.
Well, you know, paramount for this defense is trying to keep Lamar Jackson somewhat contained when he tries to run. They did a pretty good job of it there.
And you know what's so difficult for every defense that has to prepare for Lamar Jackson? You have to think and play at the same time. And I know that sounds like something you're supposed to do, but when you have to think about your assignments against him, it often slows down your feet. You don't move as fast. You've got to be prepared for this guy every step of the way and then try and match his athleticism.
So third and two, this quite possibly four down territory, though, if they're stopped. They snap it at one. Now it's Jackson.
This will go to Henry out wide.
And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line.
Nice methodical opening drive here. They're already in the field goal range. They're in a good spot. You know that people just like to take a shot in this part of the field. But at the same time, as methodical as they've been, they might want to run the ball a little bit here too.
And just on the outskirts of the red zone, they have options now. Either way, though, they've come out with a purpose. Play action. Now Jackson. And he's going to be taken down here. A sack back at the 32.
Foye Sade Aluakin.
Credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10.
Second and 20.
Three.
Another try after the first down sack. Jackson, and that'll be incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation. That's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
Here comes the seventh play of this opening drive. They've moved it well, but here's third down. Now it's Jackson. And he slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage.
Well, partner, nothing comes open here, so he decides to escape out of there, and he doesn't pick up a first down, but he does gain additional yardage to set up a possible field goal attempt if they decide to go that route.
And that is no good. No good. Wide to the left. These playoff games have a tendency to be tight. You have to wonder if that missed field goal could haunt them later.
Yeah, we're always looking for the key plays, right? The ones that we're going to magnify. Usually those happen in the second half or later in the game. This might be the key play of the game showing up here in the first half.
And a high throw there as this is knocked away down to the ground and incomplete.
So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
They have to like what they've done defensively here at the outset of this drive. They forced a couple of incomplete passes, bring up a third and 10. Don't be surprised to bring a little pressure on this snap.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. They'll drop to throw, eluding the pressure right. We'll get this complete to Jalen Reagor. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
Now that's all about making something happen as a quarterback, because instead of forcing something on third down, how about him buying some time outside of the pocket, waiting for someone to come open? And when he did, he put it on him for a big play and a first down.
It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and 4.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
The last run got 6, now second and 4. And he'll give it here to his running back. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30.